guys, welcome to my channel. Today I'm gonna update you guys on how online clinics are going and just how life in general is going on this quarantine. So first I just wanted to say that this quarantine time has been really, really tough for me, for my family, and I thank everyone because being stuck at home, it's good for a little because we definitely needed the rest, at least I know I did, but it can get exhausting and I need the sunlight. I need to get out more, but obviously we gotta stay safe and kind of think about others and make sure that we're doing the right thing. So during this time, I not only have been taking online rotations, but I've been preparing for my NAVLE, which is the board's exam to become a veterinarian here in the US. And I've been really busy. Like, I can't say that I had like all this free time to like lay around and stuff, even though I must admit that I did take more breaks than I usually do, but it's because of that. I feel like it's not the same being tired from being in the hospital all day long and like walking up and down and doing a bunch of things than being tired of just being in front of like a monitor 24/7. So as I told you guys on my coronavirus video, the school decided that it was best for us to continue our education online. And right after that, on the next Monday, we started a new set of rotations online. And mine started with equine orthopedic surgery. This rotation, I had already taken it. It was my first rotation ever, so I kind of already knew what I was getting myself into, but obviously these circumstances were completely different. Therefore, I didn't know what to expect and didn't know what I would get from it online, but it turned out to be really great, actually. I think that the doctors and the professors here at Texas A&M did an excellent job at adjusting to these circumstances. Cause I was thinking like, this is orthopedic surgery, like how am I gonna learn online about this? And they actually did a really amazing job. I'll never forget our first day of equine ortho online. It was super dynamic. Like, we had an appointment at the hospital, the doctor did. And she basically zoomed us along with the client, because remember that the clients are not able to go into the hospital yet. They have to stay outside, and then their animals come inside without them, and they communicate through Zoom or through their phone. And basically, they did the whole process with us included in the Zoom, which was pretty awesome because we went step by step and we were part of the whole process. We received the information from this client before their appointment, therefore we were more knowledgeable in the sense that we knew more about the case and we could ask pertinent history questions, which was our job. We were asked to like formulate a bunch of questions that we wanted to ask this client. And I thought that maybe I would just be telling the doctor the questions that I would think of asking, but no, it was even better than that. The client was there on the Zoom. We were able to ask her all the questions that we wanted to and then proceed. After getting this complete history, we were able to ask the doctor that we wanted to do a physical exam. So she did the physical exam on the Zoom completely, and she verbally like said all of her findings as she was doing this physical exam. So yeah, we weren't there like putting our hands on the horse and kind of doing the physical exam ourselves, but she was doing it and we were able to be part of this whole process. After that, she would ask us like, oh, so what do you want to do after these findings? And then whatever diagnostics we did, for example, we wanted to do a dynamic lameness exam. So we wanted to see this horse trot. And she was like, okay, let's do that. And then she recorded the whole thing, this whole lameness exam, and we were able to tell her what we thought about that exam and kind of like what we thought about the whole process. And after that, she asked us what diagnostics we wanted to do, why. We kind of discussed our thoughts, and it was really awesome because then we did whatever we suggested, and it was just like we were there, which was the weird part, but really cool part. And we were able to talk to the client throughout the whole time, and I thought it was pretty awesome. I think that it couldn't have gone better, honestly. The whole 2 weeks of equine ortho, it was kind of like that. So we don't have a lot of cases, right? Because this whole pandemic, it's actually affecting my hospitals too. Like, animals will come, but only on an emergency basis, or if there's appointments that they thought were important, they left them to be. But basically, since there's not a lot of appointments and a lot of things going on in the hospital, they like grouped certain rotations. For example, everyone that was taking equine ortho surgery, equine soft tissue surgery, I think it was Therio, and I'm not sure what else, they all grouped them into the same like general rotation, and it will fulfill the needs of my rotation, but then also for those people, it will fulfill the needs of their rotations too, which meant that every day we had rotations or like Zoom meetings on each different category. So we would have meetings on ortho, on soft tissue, on therio, and I thought it was really, really cool, not only because I would get something different every day and I would learn from different things, but also those were rotations that I haven't necessarily taken. So I think it will prepare me for when I actually do have those rotations. So what that means is that during those 2 weeks, I basically took a crash course rotation on equine ortho surgery, equine soft tissue, and therio, and it was really, really cool. The next 2 weeks, my rotation was equine internal medicine. This rotation, it was kind of like the same system in which they like united a bunch of rotations into one group, but I thought it was great as well because we were able to learn about different things every day. So it was mostly just like equine internal medicine itself, but we had a bunch of cool cases like neurological cases, full cases, endocrine cases. Like, I thought it was great, and not every time it was like what I said about ortho, like a real life situation where we were able to partake in it, but whenever there wasn't a case or something, I think the professors did a really good job at actually doing mock cases and going through things, and they would send us information as if the patient was there and kind of like make us part of this experience, pretending or not pretending, because honestly sometimes I couldn't even tell if it was a real patient because they gather so much information from this patient that could have been a last patient, like an old patient, right? But they had pictures, they had videos, they had a ton of like information to provide about those patients, and I think it made it really realistic and really awesome. So I think that I learned a lot from that rotation as well. My third online rotation, and just the last one I just took, was small animal soft tissue surgery. So the first thing I thought to myself is probably the same thing you're thinking, how the heck are you gonna do a small animal soft tissue rotation online? And honestly, I was skeptical at first too, because that is a rotation that I feel like a lot of students wait for or expect to have or are eager to have because it's very hands-on. You basically take on these surgeries and you do them all, maybe not by yourself, but you can do part of them. It depends on the university, but I know here in Texas, you definitely get the opportunity to do most of the surgery, if not all, of course with supervision. But these surgeries that I'm talking about are literally anything soft tissue related. It could be anything like gastropexy, cystotomy, gastrotomy, OVH, castrations, and so many more. Like, these are foreign body removals. Like, honestly, it could be anything soft tissue related, and the fact that the students have the opportunity to do all those into that rotation was something I really was looking forward to. So it was kind of disappointing to know that I was gonna take that rotation online, but I had to do what I had to do, and honestly, it surprised me. I think I learned more than I expected. At first, we had a bunch of journal assignments, which meant that we were given a bunch of articles, and we were able to look ourselves for some articles to explain and kind of like analyze and present to the other students. And, you know, I think like, damn, like, that's a lot of reading and stuff. Obviously, that's not what you would have done possibly in like the actual soft tissue surgery rotation, but I think it's the best that we can do in the sense that reading articles and staying up to date on science is, I think, the best way to practice the best medicine, especially in something so important like surgery, because there's new techniques coming out every day, and being able to talk about those and being able to kind of like distinguish between a good and a bad paper, or a paper that needs more work or more research into it, then I think it's important, because we often read some papers and are convinced of what they're saying in this paper, but then you gotta analyze how the research was done. So I learned a lot about those papers, and it really made me think about the techniques that I'm gonna use and certain things that I wanna try now, things that I actually didn't know before, and some things that I actually knew that now I know, like, confirm this is definitely a great choice. The other part of the rotation definitely consisted more on the actual surgeries that we're doing. We were all asked to present or do like a whole PowerPoint on a particular surgery from top to bottom, everything from signalment to procedure to the suture that you're gonna use, literally every single detail of the surgery, post-op complications, and like till the end, like suggestions for your owner. At first I was really nervous because my presentation was about gastroplexies on GDB patients, and I was nervous because I've actually never had the opportunity to do one of those. So I felt like I was expected to know a lot about a surgery that I've never done. But it turned out to be really good, even though I did spend a lot of hours preparing for that and like doing the presentation and making it pretty and looking for good pictures and kind of looking at different papers to see like if my information was not outdated. But it made me feel comfortable about this particular surgery. And I think that now when I get thrown into a case where I have to do a gastroplasty, I'll be completely comfortable, or at least more comfortable than I was before, because now I know like the ins and outs of the surgery, which took me a long time to prepare for. But I think it's good in the long run because when I do have the case, and I'll be able to do it. And just like I had to do those presentations, each of my colleagues had to do one as well. So in a less stressed environment, because I didn't have to present myself, I was able to listen to the presentations of other people. And it was really nice because they spent as much time in their presentation as I did. So they were really good and really engaging. They had amazing pictures, and I think that probably helped them the same way it helped me doing it, but also presenting it and receiving that information in a different way definitely helps me. So because of this, I'm sure I feel more comfortable about doing all those procedures. In the end of that rotation, we basically had an oral exam, and I was so nervous for it because, like, you know, oral exams. It was crazy because they basically gave you a signalment and you had to do whatever surgery that the doctor asked you to do. And you kind of had to pretend that like it was a veterinarian calling you and not knowing how to do a procedure, and you had to explain step by step the surgery. I got a female puppy spay, which was really cool because it's really hard, if you think about it, like doing it versus explaining how to do it. Like, you have to explain like landmarks, you have to explain distances, you have to explain like certain manures that you do naturally without thinking, you have to explain them. So that was harder, but I am glad I got that because I know how to do a spay, and I was comfortable doing it. And I thought it was even funny because you have to explain this without seeing it. Like, if you have a dog in front of you, then I can literally like see things and show you, but it's not the same when you have to verbally explain every single thing. And I guess that was the challenge for me, but I did well, and the professor thought that I did well, and that if she were to give me a dog today to do it, then that she thought that I would be great. So that's all that matters. The good thing is, I think that helped me kind of like refresh my memory in terms of doing those things, because the last time I did a spay was in Grenada, last semester, I would say November or December. During finals, I think it was when I did my last spay. So it's been kind of like a while, it's been a couple of months, and it was a good refresher for me, and I really enjoyed the rotation. So unfortunately, the next two rotations will also be online. Texas A&M decided that they're gonna plan to start actual normal physical rotations in June. So now in May, I have two rotations, and the first one being vet emergency management and triage, and my second one being radiology. So I'm really looking forward for those next two rotations because I really have minimal experience with like emergency disasters, and it's something I look forward to getting better at because, as we all know, this world has global warming and it has a bunch of things going on, and I want to be ready to help not only people but also animals in disasters. Also, radiology I think is so important because it's such a great and easy way to kind of like diagnose things, and it's something that it's definitely important to get better at when it comes to veterinary medicine. So I'm looking forward to learning a lot in that rotation. In conclusion, rotations online at the beginning was kind of good because I needed like a physical break in the sense of that I was really tired physically. I didn't sleep a lot and I was working long hours. But honestly, now that it's been all this time, I really, really miss it. And I kind of wish we could go back into the hospital and stay there and do things. And I really do miss the contact with the people, with the doctors, with the clients, and the animals, man. Like, it's such a difference. Like, it's all great, like, studying at home and stuff, but honestly, I wish I could go back to the hospital. So whatever you guys are doing, I hope you guys are staying safe at home and kind of like doing the right thing. Hopefully this will go back to normal soon, and I don't know what normal is gonna be like anymore, but I just wanna go back to doing what I love, and I'm sure you guys too. So if you guys have any questions, you like this video, please like and subscribe to my channel if you haven't. Let me know if you guys have any questions or if you guys wanna talk about anything. I am very open to letting you guys know everything about this experience. So thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you guys later.